हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू डीएडएमए। होप आप सभी का प्रिपरेशन बहुत जोर से चल रहे हैं। एज यू नो, देर आर वेरी फ्यू डेज लेफ्ट फॉर प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन, वेरी फ्यू डेज। द टाइम विच यू हैव टू बी यूटिलाइज विथ मच मोर एफिशिएंसी। व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इन द लास्ट 30 डेज दैट इज अवेलेबल, यू हैव टू मेक श्योर यू रिवाइज स्टैटिक एज वेल एज करेंट कंटिन्यूसली। बोथ स्टैटिक पार्ट एज वेल एज करंट पार्ट हैज़ टू बी रिवाइज्ड कंटिन्यूसली। तो आप कैसे रिवाइज करना है? इफ यू डिवाइड योर टाइम इन सच ए वे दैट यू डेडिकेट स्पेसिफिक टाइम फॉर स्टैटिक, यू डेडिकेट स्पेसिफिक टाइम फॉर करंट, एंड ऑल्सो यू डेडिकेट इनफ टाइम फॉर द मॉक टेस्ट। दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। तो मॉक टेस्ट में यू विल टेस्ट योर सेल्फ एंड यू विल करेक्ट योर सेल्फ। दिस इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग विद द मॉक टेस्ट। सो यू हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट यू नो स्टडी, you revise and you test. All the three things have to go on simultaneously daily, no matter what. So you have to plan in these, you have to plan in such a way in the last few days that is available. Okay, so yahan pe we are trying to help you with the revision series. So is revision series mein hum cover kar rahe hain last 1.5 year ka current affairs from science and technology. So this will be very helpful for your upcoming prelims examination. So is lecture mein, this is part 15 of the lecture. Hope you have seen other 14 parts. If not, you know, go to the playlist and watch other 14 parts. This will be very helpful for your for the prelims examination. Because yahan pe we are trying to cover both the current as well as static parts. I'm trying to explain the important concepts of the static part along with the current issues also. Okay, so make use of the things available to you so that you will pass the exam with flying colors. So is lecture mein, what are we going to see? The content for this lecture is, first we will talk about the Infosys Open Cyber Defense Center in Romania. So it was recently opened in Romania, we will talk about that. After that, hum dekhte hain automated facial recognition system ke bare mein. After that, we will talk about automated multimodal biometric identification system. Hum baat karte hain kis government launch kiya, what is this all about. After that, we will talk about the CDOT's latest innovations. हम देखते हैं उसके बाद सेंट्रलाइज टेक्नोलॉजी वर्टिकल के बारे में, बिकॉज CBI इज गोइंग टू गेट दिस टेक्नोलॉजी, व्हाट इज दिस टेक्नोलॉजी, हम देखते हैं उसके बारे में। आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द क्वांटम सुप्रीमेसी। आफ्टर दैट वी विल सी अबाउट द ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी। इन सब कुछ चीज़ों के बारे में हम देखते हैं इस लेक्चर में। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। फर्स्ट, द ओपन साइबर डिफेंस सेंटर इन रोमानिया बाय इन्फोसिस। इन्फोसिस विच इज अ टेक जायंट ऑफ इंडिया, it has launched the Open Cyber Defense Center in Romania. So Romania is a European country and the capital of Romania is Bucharest. Remember, Bucharest is the capital of Romania. This Open Cyber Defense Center, it will provide the end-to-end real-time 24/7 cyber security monitoring and protection services to support the European and global businesses on their digital transformation journey. So the digital transformation journey, man, the cyber security system, it will help. Because as you know, the greatest threat to any field which is there today is cyber threat. Because cyber threat is a very important threat, because all the day-to-day functioning is dependent on the cyberspace. So we have to make sure we have protect the cyberspace in the best possible way. So iske liye Infosys ne launch kiya cyber defense center in Romania. So this will help all the European countries in order to protect their cyberspace. It's a 24/7 monitoring system. Next one, automated facial recognition system, AFRS. So National Crime Record Bureau has released a request for the proposal of an automated facial recognition system. So with this, what will happen is the National Crime Record Bureau is trying to create a centralized database where the data of all the criminals will be there. So yahan pe kya hote, when the data is there, all the police and the law enforcement agents will be able to use this data with the NRCB, NCRB, National Crime Record Bureau. Okay, so yahan pe kya hote, this system, it will have data, it will have the facial data of all the convicts, of all the criminals in fact. So when the police or any law enforcement agency, when they need information, what they will do is they will use this data. So it will use this, they will use this data. So yahan pe an artificial intelligence will be used. This artificial intelligence, this AI, it will try to match the data which is there in the system already with the data given by the users, that is the law enforcement agencies. When they will give some data, you know, they need to identify someone, they will give some data. So this artificial intelligence will use a unique technology called neural network. It's a unique technology of पैटर्न फाइंडिंग एंड मैचिंग. सो पैटर्न फाइंडिंग एंड मैचिंग के लिए दे विल यूज दिस टेक्नोलॉजी कॉल्ड न्यूरल नेटवर्क. सो इन एग्जाम क्वेश्चन में बी आस्ड व्हाट इज नो व्हाट इज न्यूरल नेटवर्क. सो इट्स एन आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस टेक्नोलॉजी यूज फॉर पैटर्न फाइंडिंग एंड मैचिंग. आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस टेक्नोलॉजी यूज फॉर पैटर्न फाइंडिंग एंड मैचिंग. दिस इज अबाउट न्यूरल नेटवर्क. नेक्स्ट ऑटोमेटेड मल्टी मॉडल बायोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिफिकेशन सिस्टम. सो वॉट इज दिस ऑटोमेटेड मल्टी मॉडल बायोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिफिकेशन सिस्टम. सो महाराष्ट्र हैज बिकम द फर्स्ट स्टेट इन द कंट्री टू अडॉप्ट द AMBIS. सो इट एम्स टू क्रिएट अ क्रिमिनल डेटाबेस बाय एडिशन ऑफ आयरिस एंड फेस बायोमेट्रिक्स. सो अंडर दिस सिस्टम अ डिजिटल डेटाबेस ऑफ फिंगरप्रिंट्स एंड फोटोग्राफ्स ऑफ द क्रिमिनल विल बी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर द हाई कन्विक्शन रेट्स. सो महाराष्ट्र इज द फर्स्ट स्टेट. सो विच इज द फर्स्ट स्टेट? महाराष्ट्र इज द फर्स्ट स्टेट टू अडॉप्ट द AMBIS ऑटोमेटेड मल्टी मॉडल बायोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिफिकेशन सिस्टम. सो महाराष्ट्र हैज बिकम द फर्स्ट स्टेट. सो इट इज ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट अ क्रिमिनल डेटाबेस, ए डेटाबेस विद द डेटा ऑफ ऑल द कन्विक्टेड क्रिमिनल्स. सो विद दिस वॉट विल हैपन इज इट विल एनहेंस द ऑर इट विल यू कैन से इट विल इंक्रीज द कन्विक्शन रेट बाय द लॉ एनफोर्समेंट एजेंसीज. हाउ? The law enforcement agencies can speed up their investigations. They will have a lot of data. So with this data, they can identify the criminals using the data that they have or which they have collected at the crime scene. So they can identify the criminals very easily. So this will enhance the investigation time and the judgments in the court also. Okay. So for that this will be useful. So which state government? The Maharashtra. You can see the Maharashtra state government is the first state government in India to adopt this AMBIS. Next one, CDOT's latest innovation. What is CDOT? CDOT is Center for Development of Telematics. This is a central agency. So this agency is a central government which is working on latest innovations in the field of telecommunication. This has launched some latest innovations: CSAT-5, XGS-PON, and CDOT's interoperable set-top box. So these are the latest innovations. What is CDOT's interoperable set-top box? So this is a set-top box wherein which there is no need to change the set-top box when you are changing the networks. That what does that mean? That means there are a lot of technologies that are available in the market. A lot of companies, like let's say Tata Sky and Airtel. So like this, there are a lot of technologies. This Sun Direct. These are the DTH technologies which are there in the market. Okay. Now suppose if you want to change from Tata Sky to Airtel, you will have to purchase a new set-top box. But with this innovation, now there is no need to change the set-top box. With a single set-top box, you can choose the operator you want. Okay. This is the advantage of this innovation. The other innovations are, first is CSAT-5. What is CSAT-5? So generally, the telecommunication reach to remote areas is very low. So in the remote areas, the agencies will be using satellite phones. So यहाँ पे CDOT ने क्या किया? They have innovated a device in such a way that you can use Wi-Fi of your device and you can directly connect to the satellite. So using Wi-Fi, you can connect to the satellite and you will get the data directly. Okay, this is to serve the unserved areas, including the remote islands and difficult terrains. So this is a very useful innovation. Next one, CDOT's XGS-PON. It's an applications. It will help the applications like IPTV, HDTV streaming, online gaming, and host of other cloud-based services that necessitate the seamless availability of high bandwidth. So online streaming ke liye high bandwidth chahiye. So for this technology will be helpful. Next one, CVI to get centralized technology vertical. So what is the centralized technology vertical? So the center is planning to set up a centralized technology vertical under CBI, Central Bureau of Investigation. So what this will do is, this will share the real-time information among the investigators across the country. So one of the drawback that we have in the country is the law enforcement agencies, they will not be sharing data on real-time basis. So when the data is not shared on real-time basis, we are losing critical time. So iske liye ab kya kar rahe, the central government is planning to get this centralized technology vertical where the real-time data sharing happens among the law enforcement agencies. Okay, next one, quantum supremacy was in news. What is this quantum supremacy? So Google researchers claim to have achieved a major milestone in the computer science known as quantum supremacy. What is quantum technology? Quantum technology is usage of the quantum state in computing. So the quantum state is a very, you can say, it's a very highly efficient state where we are using this state in order to perform the computations in the computers. So yahan pe quantum supremacy means the researchers have been able to use a quantum computer to perform a single calculation which normal computers cannot do by itself. Even in the reasonable time, they will not be able to do. Even the super fast computers that we have in the world, even they will not be able to do this. Okay. So if you see, Prithvish is the fastest supercomputer in India. So coming back, so this quantum supremacy is a very useful technology where in future we will be seeing all the calculations, or you can say all the computing devices working on this technology. Okay, so you can say this quantum supremacy is a very great technology that we are going to get in the future. So yahan pe kya ho rahe, quantum phenomena like superposition and entanglement are being used to perform the calculations. Next one, blockchain technology. So recently T-Board of India is keen to harness the latest technology such as blockchain to help end-to-end customer track the supply chain of tea of India origin by digitizing the Indian tea marketing channels. So normally when you purchase a tea, let's say you purchase a Taj Mahal tea. This is a Taj Mahal tea. You don't know from where this tea has come. You don't know its origin. Who has grown this, which company has produced this, you don't know all of these things. So iske liye T Board of India, what they are trying to do is they are trying to use this blockchain technology where the customers can now directly know from where their good has come. So now what is this blockchain technology? I'll help you. I'll make you understand this. So let's say blockchain technology is simply, all of you about the spider web, right? So blockchain, in simple words, blockchain technology is a decentralized technology. What do you mean by decentralized? That means there is no central control authority. It's a decentralized data sharing technology where a data change at one place is reflected or is intimated to all the nodes. So everyone will know if there is any data change. For example, this is a spider web. Okay, it's simply like this. Is the mesh network is like this. So these are all the customers. So when there is any change or when there is an electrical impulse over here, all the nodes, every point will know about the electrical impulse here. This is simply the blockchain technology. A small electrical impulse or a small change somewhere in the node, in the network, everyone will know that. So everyone will know what are the things that are there in the system. Everyone will know the origin, everyone will know the end. So it's a decentralized, no one is controlling this. Everyone will know everything that is happening. So the digital technologies, or you can say the digital coins like the Bitcoin, they uses this blockchain technology. The blockchains are the new data structures that is secure and cryptographic based and distributed across the network. The technology support cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin and transfer of any digital or data asset. Okay, that is about the blockchain technology. Now let's revise what we have studied. We have seen Infosys has opened a cyber defense center in Romania. After that, we have seen about automated facial recognition system, AFRS. This automated facial recognition system will use neural network artificial intelligence technology. So the National Crime Record Bureau has opened, has floated tenders for that. After that, we have seen automated multimodal biometric identification system. Maharashtra is the first state government to implement this, where the system will have data of all the criminals, the iris and the other data, the fingerprints, iris and other biometric data. Next, C.DOT has latest innovations, the C.DOT Wi-Fi and C.DOT set-top box. These are the latest innovation by C.DOT. Next one, the centralized technology vertical, where this centralized technology vertical will help in the real-time data sharing among the law enforcement agencies and the investigating agencies. Next, we talked about the quantum supremacy. Quantum supremacy, this is achieved by Google, where the researchers have claimed that they have performed calculations which normal computers will not be able to perform easily. Next, we talked about the blockchain technology, where the T-board is searching for alternatives like blockchain technology, which can be used or which will be helpful for the customers to know origin of the T. So we have seen all of this. Okay, so that's it in this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.